A section of lawyers in Kampala are in court challenging the Land Acquisition Act they believe is inconsistent with the Constitution. They claim that government is actions of seeking court orders to deposit the money as compensation to land owners before the final resolution is illegal. These include Daniel Omara and Advocacy for Natural Resources and Development and Resources Rights Africa Limited. The Attorney General of Uganda are the respondents in this petition. The advocates contend that the practice of the government land compulsory acquisition deprives them of their rights to own property and protection.
And again, ordering that the land be taken over before court determines that whether an adequate and fair compensation has been paid is also an infringement and inconsistent with the right to protection from deprivation of property.
Under the Land Acquisition Act of 1965, government is at liberty to compulsory acquire land for construction of public utilities like roads, schools, hospitals, oil and gas pipeline, among others. The petitioner claimed that the Land Acquisition Act of 1965 is old and contradicts the 1995 Constitution, which provides for adequate compensation.
The refusal and the delay to put into place a law that provides for fair and adequate compensation is inconsistent with a right to protection from deprivation of property. Taking over property, as stipulated under the old law, the Land Acquisition Act, which provides for deposit of funds into court, and then to go ahead and take over that property before the landowner receives adequate and fair compensation, is inconsistent with the right from deprivation of property as stated under Article 26.
They also contain that under the Land and Acquisition Act, citizens have to bargain for their rights and property, which they believe it's illegal.
We are seeking orders that within a year, government and its agencies, and including Parliament, there should be a law that speaks, they should enact a law for fair and adequate compensation. And that within every 3 months, they must update court on the steps taken in enactment of that law.
Deborah Namamonde, Nantong Rebecca, UBC News.